in the cellar of an old warehouse in Matthew Street, built about the year 1850, there opened a new jazz club. It was called The Cavern. Traditional jazz was no longer the big draw. Skiffle had won the fight for a hearing. But these were national trends, too conventional for Liverpool youth. Something new was wanted, and out of the cavern there emerged a new sound. A few chords strung together on a cheap guitar. A drum for a beat. Another guitar. More chords. A bass to give balance. The Mersey beat came firm from the mold. Look at the average person,
speak to the man in the street. Well, as you can see, we're at Twickenham Film Studios, just outside London. And you can see also that everybody who goes into this place has to be security checked, because this is the place that the Beatles are making their first film. Right outside this wall, of course, the teenagers would give almost anything to get inside here. We're lucky we're inside one of the very few units that have been allowed on this top security set.
Paul, could I have your age, height, and when's the record going to be, please?
21, 5'11". The next record's going to be out soon, but I don't know when.
Where am I today? Well, in fact, I'm standing in Oxford Street, and behind me is the very famous Air Studios, where lots of very, very famous people record all their very famous records. And I'm just standing here waiting for one very famous person.
Should we get in a taxi?
Let's get in a cab.
Come on in, girls. Morning, girls. How are you? All right.
Oh, I know. Isn't she precious?
Hello. All right, yeah. See ya. See what you caused now on this trouble.
I know, it's wonderful.
Typical, isn't
it? I thought you weren't coming. I was standing out there for ages. I thought you weren't
coming. I
nearly
thought better of it for a minute there, but...
There you go.
How are you doing? We're going to stop meeting like this.
I know.
It's silly, you know.
I feel like I'm cheating,
like
meeting
what?
You like this. Outside Air Studios. How have you been?
Oh, nice.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So?
Working hard. Thank you.
It's all closed. So, what have you been doing in Air Studios?
Just sitting around, generally watching all the people and that. Doing a bit of music and stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is this you causing all this stuff?
No. I've got a funny feeling it's probably you. Look at the average person, speak to the man on the beat. Can you imagine the first one you
meet? I've just been doing some film music.
Oh, really?
O'Reilly.
Is that for,
Broad Street?
Broad Street?
Yeah.
I've heard, Pipes of Peace.
Peace of Peace, yeah.
brilliant album. Was it true that it was actually going to be a tug of war double album?
Yeah. But you know, record companies don't like double albums.
No.
They panic. So we said, well, we'll split it into two, Tug of War 1 and Tug of War 2. But then it suddenly got to be a boring idea.
Oh, right.
It was like,
You had so many songs left over, I suppose.
We had a couple left over, yeah. But then we decided to make it into Pipes of Peace instead, so it was like the opposite of the last album, instead of just a follow-on.
Yeah, so it's actually an answer to Tug of War.
Sort of, yeah.
Mm. I think it's brilliant, in fact. But,
thank you, Les.
Thank you. Well, what I was going to say was, because George Martin, you've... last time you worked with George Martin was Live and Let Die, isn't that right?
Mm.
And how did it come about, you working with him again?
To work again? Well, I'd been producing a lot of my own stuff, and it's hard work, you know, producing it and singing it, and wondering if you've done a good vocal take, and then you've got to sort of run around and listen to it and say, yes, you were good, and then run out and say, oh, was I? Yes, you know, and it's a bit schizophrenic. If you've got all the ideas and know exactly what you're going to do, it's okay, but if you start ad-libbing and busking, it's really difficult, and it's nice to have somebody else there who says, you were lousy, do it again.
Is it nice to have the freedom to work with everyone you want to now?
Yeah.
Because you always used to play a lot yourself, didn't you?
Yeah, I still play a lot of instruments myself. Well, the trouble with that is it gets a bit boring, it gets a bit lonely. You suddenly realise you're in the studio, like, where's the mates? You know, just sitting there, and now the next track. And, you know.
Yeah.
So it just got a bit lonely, really, so it's nice having other people there. Plus, anyway, I think it's better just playing live with people, you know. There's some magic when you play live.
Yeah.
It brings out stuff in you. What? Here we are, going past the hallowed halls of the BBC.
Oh, yes, this is the BBC over here.
Hey, all right, Tony?
Wonderful building, wonderful building.
Yeah.
So what was it like with Michael Jackson, working with Michael Jackson?
Very easy. A lot of people think, because he's shy, that he might be difficult to get on with. But he's really great. He just is shy. And he's a little bit uncomfortable doing interviews. But I can understand that, because it's a funny situation, you know, as we know. So he's great. When you meet him, he's just a real normal fella. Well, as normal as you can be in that position.
I try and picture you two writing. How do you write together?
Well, he came over, he wanted to write songs with me. He said he wanted to make hits. So I said, great, come on. So I just got a guitar and just started plonking around, plonking, plonking, just trying to get something going. And I could see when he liked something, I could see when I was getting somewhere, and he started throwing little ideas in and stuff. And we had put it down on cassette, and we had about half of the idea. And then he took it back to his hotel. Hello, demo. Let Peking Dogs Lie. It's a dog demo.
Oh, well.
All right, brothers. So he just came around. Then he came back the next day, and he'd done a lot of words to it. So it's just a to and fro thing, you know.
So the movie, Give My Regards to Broad Street.
Yeah. It's about losing some tapes to a new album. I don't want to tell you too much of the plot, because when we were making the film, the producer kept saying, don't tell anyone what it's all about, you know, because it'll be a surprise when it comes out. But then, you know, people do want to know vaguely what it's about. So there's some tapes to a new album which go missing. And I've got some fella who works for me has got a criminal record in the film. And so everyone suspects him of nicking the tapes.
Right.
So you have to go and see the film to see if he nicked them or not.
When's it coming out?
Summer of 84, I think.
Oh, brilliant, brilliant. Yeah. We're just coming into Regent's Park now. Is there anywhere particularly you would like to go?
Should we go by the zoo?
By the zoo?
We go right round by the zoo. You would notice the architecture here is Nash. And it was all built for Prince Albert, Prince Regent.
I love these houses along here. They're so wonderful. Yeah. Cost an arm and a leg.
I know. I tried to live in one of them once, and the residents didn't want me because I was a pop star. So I moved away, and I'm glad I did. You can stick it!
I actually nearly ran over Jimmy Savile coming down here. He was jogging, and he jogged straight out of my car one day.
I thought you would have been on the train.
So what else do you want me to ask you? Millions of things you would like me to ask you.
Why don't you ask me how I like the Tube?
How do you like the Tube?
Rubbish. No, I think it's a good show. I do like it. No, honest, I do. I didn't think the interview with Mick was too good. I thought the girl doing it put him too much on the defensive. You know, he ended up explaining it all the way. But
What did you think of the video itself?
I thought what he said, you know, that it was a song about repression, so it had to be some violence. It wouldn't look silly otherwise. I thought they made a big fuss. Not them, you know, the BBC made a bit of fuss, like they usually
do. Banning it. But there again, he must have done fairly well out of it, by it being banned and lots of publicity.
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah, it helped it really, didn't it, in the end?
Yeah.
Good luck to him, say I. Well, I mean, it's a good record. I think it's a good record.
It is a good record. It is.
Undercover. Great. I know all the words myself. Regent's Park. You know it was called the Regent's Park?
No, why?
Prince Regent, Prince Albert. Victoria's husband, she had it built for him.
What, the whole park?
Regent, yeah, it's true. And Regent Street.
She must have actually really loved him because she had that incredible statue in Kensington opposite the Albert Hall done for him as well, you know.
He had his own hall too, yeah. I think she did, you know.
She must have been all right for a bob or two.
Yeah, that's no way to talk of a previous monarch. All right for a bob or two.
I was listening to the radio, and you know this award that Liverpool have got? Are you going to all accept it?
Freeman of the City.
Yeah, Freeman of the City. Because
yeah, I think
all
so,
waiting,
yeah.
They were waiting, because if one of you said no, then they weren't going to let you have it.
Yeah, it's weird, you know. I'll accept it. I'll have anything
well,
going.
One.
There's one down, yeah. Are you watching councillors of thing the goats go on?
You what, know, mountain
the
goats?
Zoo, Regent's Park Zoo. In fact, we might see the odd goat
leaping. You're not trying to bunk in around the back, are you?
Well, I thought we might, you know, just do a quick bunk in. Should we sit down?
Oh, that's very kind of you. Come and take the weight off your slingbacks.
Yeah. Well, see, there's a few goats up there on the mountain.
Where? Oh, yeah,
some
look.
Goats up there.
Look at that.
Distant goats.
This is the cheap way to yeah. visit the zoo.
No, we can't use you today, I'm afraid. No.
Sorry. No dancing. So, I want to know more about this album.
Well, it's called Peeps of Pice. Very easy title to remember. What do you want to know about it?
Well, I want to know. It's what one. The track I really love that. See, I thought, when I listened to all the lyrics, I thought, God, your wife is such a lucky lady because the lyrics were so lovely, they really are. And the one I like is, and of course the girls going to forget it, is Through Love.
Through Our Love, yeah.
Through Our Love is wonderful.
Do you like that one? It's funny, my kids like that one.
We can go through our love. We can do things.
When I'm talking about love, I'm talking about Lynn and the kids. That's what it is for me. Mm-hmm. But I like the thought that other people can use them for their own things. You know, a couple of young marrieds, that song fits perfect for them too.
Mm.
Looking at life and looking at what's their future going to be, well, through our love, you know. It can be seen as soppy, that kind of stuff. It's dangerous writing just a straight love song, because I know people can easily just say, oh, God, you know, here's another soppy love song. But if you do like it, and if you do like those kind of feelings, you just have to say, sod it, I'm going to do it, you know, because I like that kind of thing.
What about Tug of War with Stevie Wonder? What was Stevie Wonder like to work with?
Stevie was great. He's got no sense of time. You know, if you ask him to come at 11 in the morning, we asked him around for lunch one time. He's great, by the way, he's great. But if you want to know, like, what he's like, it's... Lynn was cooking something for him. We asked him around about 11. I kind of rang him up and said, I'm just coming out the door. But about 10 o'clock that night, he showed up. And there's our Linda with his charred lunch. And I say, oh, you're here then, Stevie. Great, you know. So he's his own man.
He's got a good sense of humour.
Yeah, he's funny. He's real truth is he's a brilliant musician. You know, that's what it's down to.
We were in New York, and Jules actually was lucky enough to get an interview with Stevie Wonder. And the first thing he said to him is, haven't we met before? And so Jules said to her, no, I don't think so. So now he says, I thought your face looked familiar. And it was just so...
How does he do that?
So sweet.
Is he kidding?
Kidding?
Yeah, I know he must be kidding. No, but they do. He does use kind of sighted words. He said, see you, I'll see you and all that. And at first I was a bit nervous, you know, like, I think you do get with blind people because you don't want to offend them and yet you don't want to patronise them. So I was kind of, you know, trying madly not to use all these sort
now
of
look
see
here.
You, look here and all that, you know. But we ended up, I ended up going like, guess who it is, you know, doing all the things. He doesn't care.
No.